not going to make it. I'm going to try again. JJ's fish and chips were very nice.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Can't really see much, it's just quite a way to the beach from here. Yeah, yeah, you can see the sea. It's a bit rough out there though, eh?
It's the wind.
Yeah.
The wind is heavy. Especially when you're camping.
Hey. I can just imagine if Struisbaai is this busy, what Agulhas looks like, eh?
Do you think it's even busier?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, today marks the start, really, of when people begin their holidays.
We noticed it when we came off that gravel road onto the tar road, coming towards Struisbaai. It was very busy, eh? Just arrived in Agulhas, where the Atlantic and the Indian Oceans meet. And the lighthouse.
The lighthouse escaped me.
Yep. And now we're going into the Agulhas National Park. Very, very rough. Had a bit of gravel road, back onto the paved.
Literally.
Look at the lighthouse from this side. It's massive, eh? Okay, so this is where I wanted to come to it, but there it is. That's the southernmost point over there. And I'm heading to the southernmost point of Africa, where the Indian Ocean and the Atlantic Oceans meet. So I've been close by, but I've never been to the exact southernmost tip of Africa, which I think many people have done it, but it's my first time, so very interesting for me. Sometimes they say you can see where the two oceans meet, see two different colors. I'm gonna see if that's the truth and see if it really is like that. But from looking at the ocean the way it is now, I don't see any difference in color. check out this map of Africa. Crazy. Massive. So is the mountains and everything. Get a laugh. There are so many people taking their pictures at the Southernmost tip that I have to wait my turn. So yeah, and with COVID you got to mask up. A lot of people don't. And at this stage the virus is spreading like crazy in South Africa again, so. But yeah, let me take my, wait my turn and I'll do it. Interesting. That's exactly where the Indian and the Atlantic oceans meet, eh? Wow. Let's see if I can get a selfie with this. There's the Atlantic Ocean. I'm panning around. And there's the Indian Ocean. Weird to think. That was the southernmost tip of Africa. I was there. I don't feel any different. But I can say I've been there, I've got pictures to prove it. Yeah, I didn't see any difference in the ocean. The color looks the same. So I suppose it can happen on a calm day. Today the ocean's pretty rough, the wind's blowing, so I don't think you'll be able to see something like that, if it is at all possible. But you know, maybe they did see it. It makes sense to me because the Indian Ocean is a warm current and the Atlantic Ocean is a cold one. So where the two meet, I suppose there could be a dividing line, a separation, a difference in color and definitely in temperature. I don't know what will happen. Will the one go under the other, over the other? But with it like this, this is like a boiling pot now. It's mixing everything up, so you're not going to see any difference in the lines. Okay, I just want to take that road, that gravel road where I turned off, see what where it takes us a little bit further down to the park, to the Agulhas National Park. I don't know what one will see there further. I don't know if any of you have watched that program called The Curse of Oak Island. And now recently they've just discovered that cobblestone road that was built hundreds of years ago where they suspect they took the treasures up. They might come and dig up, yeah, they might find a few treasures too. I was just gonna say, it's not often you find a gravel road along the beach, along the sea, but check the shipwreck out. Wow. These are the fishermen from Mpumalanga. You close too.
Yeah.
Okay, after a bit of a quick search on the internet, we found out that this was the Meisho Maru 38. It was a Japanese fishing vessel that was out here fishing and then got caught up in a storm and crashed right here in front of the lighthouse or shipwrecked or whatever you call it. On the rocks.
1982.
16 November 1982. All the apparently there were 17 crew members.
Yeah.
They survived. It's just the ship that
they swam to safety. Oh, look there.
Now let me go that route first.
Oh, this is the same.
If you want it, you want me to go there, I'll go there. This is the Agulhas National Park, Star Village.
Oh. Are we allowed up here?
No, there's nothing that said no entry. What are you laughing?
You're crazy. Two staff quarters. Oh, just they made turbines out of empty coke bottles. Did you see that?
No. Pretty steep. We're not gonna make it. I'm gonna try again.
Why don't we just turn around?
Let me try one more time. Don't you want to?
No, I'm just scared we get stuck. Look at this.
We won't get stuck, we'll run back again.
Alright. It's up to you.
I'll try one more time. I don't think I'm going to make it, but I'm going to try.
But I think you need to do it first.
I'm going to. More momentum. I'm gonna go turn around and try the other way, see? It's too sandy. On our way back down again. Well, this is the closest I'm gonna get to the lighthouse. Just decided to stop here and have a look, show you what it looks like. Okay, we've arrived at our place of accommodation, our room to stay. It's called The Gift here in Agulhas. Let me show you what our place looks like. There you go, bedroom, little kitchenette, shower, basin and dunny. That's it, all we need. So we're going to call it quits for today. Thanks for watching and thanks for joining us. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below, and then we'll carry on in the next one.